This Fire Ant Queen has traveled for miles on her nuptial flight, finally landing atop a sandy mound deep in the swamp. The vantage point might seem like an ideal home, but it may be short-lived. This whole area is liable to flooding, and nearby rainfall is already causing the groundwater to rise. Exhausted and without her wings, the Queen is unable to move on alone. But if she can amass enough daughters in time, the colony as a whole may stand a chance. A great blue skimmer, Libellula vibrans, hunts overhead. This fantastic aerial predator shouldn't cause any trouble for the ants. That is, unless it decides to land in their way. Many nearby creatures have already been washed out of their homes by the rising water. A lucky few have been deposited on the shores east of the nest. As more arrive, tensions will rise. There isn't space here for everyone. Food is abundant, but as the floodwater begins to rise, the ants will quickly lose access to the lower lands. This colony must remain small for now. Food is too scarce to support greater numbers. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. The ants must protect the queen. Thank you. an ant has found itself entangled on the sticky tentacle of a dwarf sundew. As it tries to struggle free, more tentacles are drawn in, drowning the victim in thick mucilage. The boggy earth at the base of the mound is now saturated, and as night approaches, the water begins to creep closer. The new arrivals will rush to higher ground, heading straight for the nest. There is nowhere else to go. Amongst the melee of panicking creatures are larvae of the false bombardier beetle. Already large and accomplished predators, they will hold their ground against small groups of ants. The inundation has slowed, and fewer creatures are washing up to the east. The ants have an opportunity to explore for food, but there are other dangers at night. Moist-skinned amphibians have come out to take advantage of this new water world, harvesting lost insects displaced from their burrows. Thank you. A Pinewood's tree frog, Gila femoralis, has wandered into the trail. This one has taken a break from mate calling for a quick meal, and it seems that ants are on the menu. An ant has fallen victim to a carnivorous plant. There are intruders in the nest. Continued rainfall is about to bring another torrent flushing through the bog, carrying with it a slew of ill-tempered arthropods. Thank you. the ants must defend themselves. There are intruders in the nest. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. There are intruders in the nest. The ants must protect the queen. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. The ants must protect the queen. The colony is starving. There's not enough food to feed the new brood. An ant has fallen victim to a carnivorous plant. The workers have done all they can to improve these food stores. The battle has begun. There are intruders in the nest. With nowhere to drain, the floodwater creeps ever nearer to the nest. Already cramped and irritated, a panic ensues, and the refugees scramble for higher ground. News of the insect feast has spread across the swamp. With growing numbers of amphibians patrolling the waters, the Invictor's scavenging expeditions will need to be well defended. An eastern newt, Notophthalmus viridations, is devouring ants. Growing up to 10 centimeters in length, it dwarfs other creatures on the mound. Its red skin is toxic and serves as a warning to potential predators. A colony of little black ants marooned on a smaller section of the mound may be reachable if the fire ants join together to bridge the gap. Must fight. As if the colony didn't already have enough to deal with, the Great Blue Skimmer has chosen this moment to touch down right outside the nest. Unchecked, this titan of the sky will no doubt disrupt colony activities, but if the soldiers are able to bring her down, the rewards could be mighty. Little black ants have been defeated. The fire ants must pillage the nest quickly and hurry home while they still can. Thank you. The ants must defend themselves. The workers have done all they can to improve these food stores. As the water draws ever nearer, more insects begin to wash up on the bank. The Invicta colony must maintain control or risk being overrun. Her wings weighted down with fire ants, the skimmer no longer has the strength to take off. There are intruders in the nest. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. An ant has fallen victim to a carnivorous plant. Again, the floodwaters rise. The washed-up invertebrates panic, and a stampede ensues. The Invicta soldiers must form ranks quickly. An ant has fallen victim to a carnivorous plant. The battle has begun. Crippled by relentless stings, the great skimmer's attempts to flee became ever more futile. Finally collapsing atop the mound, she succumbs to the fire ants. Dismemberment will follow. By joining their bodies together to form a giant raft, the fire ants were able to ferry the queen from the mound just as the nest filled with water. Their perils are not over, but they have shown great resilience and an ability to survive in this harsh environment. Wherever they land, the creatures of the swamp will quickly come to know the might of the fire ants.